Hey, how are you? How are you? I just recently uploaded a video about how to rig it with this tool, but I didn't mention, explain the arm trick so the IK works perfectly. So, for this one, I will teach you how to use it. For this, I will be using this model that I was working with Luis Cadavid. And the trick is really simple. You just need to put the clavicle wherever you want, it doesn't matter. You place it where it goes. I won't focus on the clavicle in this video, but the clavicle must go near the spine so this move exactly like the clavicle would work. So something around there will be fine. And the shoulder, elbow, and wrist needs to be in a coplanar situation. What does that mean? For example, I will be putting the shoulder where I want the shoulder to be. In this case, it's going to be around there. And then the wrist. Okay, for the elbow to work, we need to make this a coplanar situation. So what I mean by that is create a plane and do a coplanar situation. So let's create a plane. Let's move the pivot to this edge right here. And match the transformation between this plane and the shoulder. You can use this tool, poop. Match transformations, there you go. It matches the scale also, so doesn't matter. We just rescale it, okay? So just do it like this and grab the wrist and make these two vertex match the wrist. There we go, we got a plane. And that's a plane situation, right? Now we just need to do a edge loop where the elbows goes around there, and maybe move the elbow back, but in an object that matters, so it move in the same plane, and snap this elbow. Sorry, this elbow to the plane vertex, and you are done. This is a planar situation. If you see, if you create the joint, the arm, I really recommend you to do this. Grab the rigging IK and from 2 to 4 and try the IK. If it lets you move it until the end, it's working. If not, you need to replantate it the whole situation. So for example, if this was in a coplanar like this, and you create a IK, it will break eventually. You see? It breaks. So if the thing is planar, it's much, much better. So that's the little trick I mentioned about. And if you see like this, it will work perfectly. So let's try it, and it's working. You see? Okay. That will be the quick tip about how to create the pull vectors. It works for the elbow and wrist, and for the leg and the ankle. In this case, no, because it's a quadruped, but in the outer rig, it works exactly the same. If it's coplanar, it will work.